most of my videos are based on the quality of the dog work. I want people to see that we have a different way of training that creates a different level of steadiness. I decided it's time to do a new series of videos. We're going to call this The Art of Wingshooting Over Dogs. It's going to include some different topics, the timing, associations, consistency, the things that are very important in this new way to manage dogs. And one of those topics is going to be handling, where I'm going to go into videos that show myself or Reagan or Kate or someone handling the dogs, and I'll describe what they're doing at that moment, what the priorities are in the handling, what you're expecting to see, so you can handle dogs of this caliber. There's a lot to see here in this 15-second video. I'm probably going to produce this video three or four times, and each time we'll go over something different that's in it. Today, the first one we're going to do, this is Reagan working a Kahi. And I want people to understand Kahi is on point, and what Reagan's job is to pay attention to the dog. Don't worry about the bird. Forget about the bird. You'll get plenty of bird shooting. In this video, you'll see Reagan is demonstrating some of the important things that we do when we handle these dogs. Number one, manage your energy. You're there to help the dog manage its energy, but you're also there to manage your own. Don't get excited. Don't say anything. Don't get in a hurry. Everything is calm like a walk in the park. When we're in position to shoot, we give the dogs an all right cue. On the all right cue, the dog is given permission to go with us when we go in to flush the bird. It's a reward for having pointed. It's part of teamwork. We say all right, they can go in if they like, the bird flushes, but they understand they are not to chase. They are to do an immediate stop to that flush. He gives her the all right, which gives her permission to help him flush if she wants to. The bird flushes, and you look at what Reagan does. When the bird flushes, he's looking at the dog. That is our number one rule. It's very difficult for wing shooters to do that, especially if they have a lot of bird hunting experience. You want to look at that bird on the flush, but you can't. You have to be looking at the dog. You'll have plenty of time. You look at the dog when the bird flushes, okay? The bird goes. Reagan's looking at the dog. She's nice and steady. He swings. He goes bang, and as soon as he goes bang, his attention comes back to her. Okay? He then looks at her, she's steady, he makes sure that she's settled, and he tells her to hunt dead. Now, if you look at a Kahi, she's very calm, handling her energy very well. She waits there, she understands what's going to happen. Reagan says, all right, the bird flushes, and you watch what she does. It goes bang, and when it goes bang and the bird falls, you can see her take a step sideways and kind of to the front. And that's good. There was no intent in that to chase a bird, so she was not unsteady. She was moving to the side so she could see where it fell, so she could go get it when he said hunt dead. But that's important. Don't call your dog unsteady because it moved. That's not necessarily it. Think of it like this. Steadiness is not about movement. It's about intent. What was the intention of the move? Is it to move so you can see where the bird fell? Is it a movement to manage a bird that's running so the dog can get it stopped? As long as the dog's movement in a birdie area is not about seeing a bird or flushing a bird, as long as the movement that you see is about management, getting the bird to stop running, setting it up, presenting it to the guns, and all of these careful, thoughtful things that they do are beautiful to see. If they go in with an intent to flush it or chase it, that's wrong. Our dogs don't do that. In order to see all the beautiful things these dogs are capable of and how they manage birds and how they hunt, it's important to give them the free will to manage their bird. They are the ones making the choice. In the big picture, the bird is in charge of everything because it's the one that's training the dog. It's the one that's calling the shots. Let your dogs manage the birds and you'll see a lot of neat stuff.
Good work.